just pulled into the golf course today. We got a three-day camp starting. 13 students. This is the second day of the three-day school. Yesterday, I presented the Mo Norman model to the students, went through just the efficiency of the golf swing, kind of what we look for. I want everybody to be very clear. One of the first things we do in the golf school is get clarity on what we are trying to achieve in the movement of the golf swing. So that's the very first thing, and it's really effective because the students ask questions about their body position. Then we can start getting feedback, direct feedback on whether they're matching the Mo Norman model. So a very important day was yesterday to get clarity on the model and see the students' efficiencies and see where they need to improve, starting, you know, address and all the positions of the swing, and then down into impact, finish, release. I have a whole process that I work them through to get them in the correct address position and then start working through the golf swing. So today is day two of the golf school. Today, we're gonna be working on the motion of the body. So we're gonna be talking about the three basic metrics, rotation, bend, side bend of the body, in the motion. So we start taking the things we learned yesterday and working into the motion of the swing. So today is a fun day as well. But I wanted to bring up a point that the students brought up yesterday, and they asked the question about practicing. And I bring this up a lot in golf schools about trying to help people become better and more efficient in the time they spend, become better people, better at practicing. But practice is, a lot of people don't like to practice, and that's interesting to me, but we'll talk about that. But here's the thing about it, and so one of the things I want to tell all of you out there, the way you improve, and this is my message to you today, is you can run to the range, and you can work on your swing, and you can try things, and you can, and I hate the word try, but you can try certain things and see if they work, and try to get results. Look, let's just step back for a moment, and let's just do something. I want you to raise your standards. If you're gonna improve and make massive improvement and go from where you are now to where you wanna be, not just one little bit better, not just, oh, I wanna be one shot better in my scoring, or I wanna be a little bit better in my golf swing. I'm talking, let's take you to where you're great. Let's take you from where you are now to where you're massively improved. All you have to do is, if you raise your standards to that level, so let's say you go from where you are now to a perfect golf swing, right? Let's just use your imagination and take you there, all right? I gotta raise your standards. Now, to get to this standard, right, of a perfect golf swing where you're a scratch golfer and you're great, tell me what has to happen from the where you are now to this. You gotta become better at practicing. You gotta become better at thinking. You gotta use your time better. You gotta do all these things at that standard, right? Think about it. So the first thing you do to get better is not go practice. The first thing you do is you raise your standard, raise your expectation of yourself, and then build the plan backward. What do I gotta do to get to that standard? And you're gonna totally change the way you approach it. Your disciplines will change. Let's take fitness, for example. You can go try to lose 2 or 3 pounds, right? That's probably easy. Just eat a little bit better, right? But if I say, I want you to lose 50 pounds and get in the best shape of your life, I want you to raise your standards to where you're a fitness model, right? To where you're in perfect shape and you're perfectly fit. What are you gonna do? You're gonna do a totally different set of things. You're gonna basically say, okay, I need a workout schedule. I need an eating plan. I'm gonna go see an expert on nutrition. I'm gonna go work with a fitness trainer. I'm gonna work out 5 times a week versus 2 times a week, right? So notice how, because you changed your standard, the process of your thinking changed. That's what I want you to do with your swing. So here's what I want you to think about today, and I'm gonna walk you through some thought processes about practice. Okay, so let's raise your standard right now. Raise your standard to where you have a fantastic single plane golf swing and you hit the ball perfectly long and straight. Raise your standard to where when you put your swing up next to Mo Norman's swing, it's perfect, right? Okay, so now, but you're not there, right? But that is what you expect of yourself. I expect to be here. Okay, how are we gonna get there? Number one, let's talk about how you practice. People do not practice correctly. Because number one, when they go practice, when you go to the range, let's say you're gonna go to the range today and practice, do you know what you're practicing? For example, your address position. Do you know where your grip should be? What is the standard for your grip? Do you know, is it correct? Is your setup correct? Is your body position correct? Are your alignments correct? Is your backswing correct? Is your downswing correct? Where are you at impact? Is your knee position correct? Okay? I'm just telling you that these are the things that you can monitor very easily through some practice. Now, do you know what you're practicing? For example, today I'm going to go to the range. What am I going to do? I'm going to do a quick address position check, check my address position. Then I'm going to work on my release position. I'm going to work on how I feel. I want to get stronger in my release position. Okay, so I'm going to work on a few things. I have them in my mind that I want to work on. I'm going to go work on that. My goal is to make my swing as strong and as solid as possible. So I got some things in my mind that I'm going to work on. That's number one. Number two is you must monitor, get feedback on whether you're getting what you want. For example, I'm gonna take a video, iPad down there. I'm gonna videotape my practice session. I'm not gonna videotape the whole thing. I'm not gonna spend an hour videotaping. I'm gonna occasionally click it on and watch and see if my swing is doing what I want it to do. It's very simple to do. Then I'm gonna compare myself to the model, the single plane Mo Norman model. So I'll do a couple comparisons. So I have ways of monitoring my practice. So number one, you gotta know what you're practicing. Number two, you have to know if you're getting what you want by feedback, right? Number three is you have to raise your standards so that it's just not about, I got a little bit better. You have to raise your standards much higher. The people that I see improve the most, and this is experience, my experience as a coach for 20 years, the people that I see improve the most, that make dramatic, radical improvements, have raised their standards. They come to me and they say, Todd, I don't only want to be a better golfer. I want to win my club championship. Todd, I don't want to just be a better golfer. I want to be a great ball striker, and I want to be able to shoot 72 when I play, and I want to be able to hit every shot perfectly straight. I want to go from hitting at 200 yards to 250 yards. They raise their standards to a very dramatic level. They almost make it to where it seems unachievable. It's just outside their reach. But see, that's what's important about this message here, is that me as your coach, my job is not necessarily to make you a happy golfer. Like, for example, you come take a lesson. Well, how do you feel about that? Good job. No, that's not the way I coach. My coach is to push you past your current level of thinking and your current ability. I'm here to make you a bit uncomfortable so you get to the next level. I'm trying to reach you. I'm trying to set your standard higher and say, you know what? I really like the fact that your 8-iron flies 120 yards now, right? And that you're able to hit it pretty good, but we can be better. See, as a coach, that my instruction is to get you better. Let me tell you a quick story. This happened to me. I was playing the Canadian Tour in 1995. The 1985 was a very transitional year for me. I'd spent 2 years. I'd been working on Mo Norman's golf swing for 2 years after playing on various tours when I first turned pro in 1991. I started practicing the single plane swing. I was okay. Matter of fact, I'd been in Golf Digest. They featured me in Golf Digest in 1995. I was okay, but deep down in my mind, I still had a lot to learn. Well, I was at an event in Toronto. I was playing an event there, and Mo was having lunch with me, and you know, he'd been watching me practice and hit balls. He said, Todd, he goes, you won't believe your eyes when you get it. You won't believe your eyes. And what he meant by that was, number one, you got a lot to work on still. You're not there yet. But number two is he said, you basically have so much more potential. So he said, hey, look, you're at where you're at, you're able to play, but there's so much more potentials and you won't believe it when you get there. So keep working at it because there's so much potential there. So Mo was telling me, look, start reaching your potential. Keep going after it. You won't believe your eyes. Just keep going. So he was motivating me to keep stretching my potential. He didn't say, good job, you're getting it. Nope. He said, you won't believe your eyes when you get it. Keep pushing yourself. So I'm here today to have you push yourself. I want you today to sit down and say, you know what? What if I thought differently about this? I don't want to just be a little bit better. I want to be dramatically better and set a high standard for yourself. You decide what that standard is, but make it almost where it's unachievable. And then work yourself backwards from that and say, how do I get there? And see if you're disciplines don't change. See if you don't think differently about it and see if you don't take different action steps to get there. And I want to know what that plan is. So anyway, post your comments below on this video. I'd love to hear your comments. If you have any questions, let me know. If you have any videos or anything you want to see or learn about the single plane swing, post it below. I'll produce a video on it and be nice, because some of you guys out there make negative comments, and no use in doing that because I'll delete them anyway. So anyway, thanks for watching the channel, and we'll talk to you soon.